For the people at Grace Eyre's Day Centre, the services are integral to their social life. As if living with a learning disability or mental health issue isn't difficult enough, the government have now cut these care services. The group is fighting back and have held a coffee morning to raise awareness of the suffering that these cuts have caused.
Okay, so this campaign now has started. What we're trying to do is call out to other organisations, other people with learning disabilities, to get in touch with us and to join the campaign so that we can keep the momentum going. We've already got the Green councillors on side and we're going to try and work with them as much as we can to make sure that the voice of learning disabled people in Brighton and Hove doesn't go away and kind of is listened to. If people who come to Grace Eyre have their day services cut, they lose all their social lives. For most of them, the only time they get out of their houses is to come here. Not only do they lose their social lives, but they lose contact with their friends. So their boyfriends, girlfriends, partners, etc. People they've seen for like 30 to 40 years, suddenly they'll have no contact with at all. And that is just awful.
At the day centre, it's like one big family.
We need our services and it's very important because this is all we've got.
Devastated. I'd be like climbing up the walls. I'd be like phoning up my mum, telling my mum I couldn't come here no more.
And nobody's happy with the cuts whatsoever anyway. Nobody is. And they shouldn't be doing it anyway. And it's very wrong of them.
Well, the feedback from today, it has been brilliant. Everyone thought that the campaign launch film was very good. And they think that we're all doing a great job starting it happening. I think people are very concerned that the cuts are just being done to people and that no voice is coming through to campaign against it. And I think what we're trying to do here is not let that happen.
Hopefully something could be done so that these people aren't left isolated. This is Holly Keogh for Latest TV News.